Alrighty, hello guys, welcome your faces back to another video on my channel. Today we are back in Stormworks yet again, and today we're continuing on with our IFV. Now, as you guys can see right here, it is actually looking okay at the moment. It does actually move now, albeit very slowly, and yeah, it actually is driving, which is awesome. You guys are going to see in a second that it does actually float, because it is driving off the edge of the cliff. And honestly, I wasn't entirely sure what I wanted to do today, because it was either we upgraded the engine and we made it nicer and stronger and more powerful, which we will do in the future. We're not going to do that today. Or we actually add some, we add some interior to it, which is something that I kind of want to do. So let's go ahead and get on with that. Oh, and this is it floating. Just as a side note, this is it floating. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and design the inside a little bit more now, because I feel like that's somewhat a good idea. What we're going to do is we're going to grab the driver's seat, we're going to cut it, and we're going to move it to this side. Yes, we are. All right, the next thing we're going to do is cut this and also move this to the side. And we're going to do the same thing with this and also this. Cut them. Hang on. Wait, where's the thing? Oh, it's already gone. Okay. Right, all we need is this then. Cut this, move it over, paste it in right there, and spawn it, merge it together. There we go. All right, wow. All right, fill all that in. The other thing that needs doing is we actually need a gunner's seat. We do. We need a gunner's seat. Now, if I can, the gunner is going to sit on this side and essentially just have one of these, and that'll be okay. So delete those two. Let's get ourselves a seat. And I think it'll just be one of these. There we go. We could just have it just like so. And we could do this. One and two. And there we go. So gunner on this side, driver on this side. I think that's fine. The other thing that I would like to do, actually, is to grab this piece. Grab this piece from here. Cut it and move it inwards. Paste it there. And merge that together. And then maybe, just maybe, we could take this. Cut it. Move it in. And paste it there. Unfortunately, that's going to delete something else, isn't it? It is. But what? What is it going to delete? I think it might be fine. Oh, but it's not. It's not. I want it to work, but it won't. Okay, so it is my job to design the interior of this by adding some like seats and stuff like that. So that's what we're going to do now, I think. All right, so how do we actually want to go about doing this then? There is multiple ways of obviously doing it. I'm going to go ahead and delete both sides. We're going to have both sides on the back be the same, which is fine. That is okay. We're going to go ahead and do this like so. We're going to go ahead and add these guys up here like this, and that should be fine. We then need to add the actual seats in, which I think are just going to look like this, and go to there. Or maybe not. Maybe we don't want them like that. They might actually just be like this. There we go. Add those in. Get ourselves some seats. Here we go. These guys. And seemingly just whack these in. So one there, two, three, four, five. Yes. Okay. Whack that in right there. Whack this in right here. And that is it. So if we were to transport troops, we got one, two, three, four, five. So we got 10 seats in the back, as well as a gunner and also a driver. That seems pretty good. That seems pretty good. Yeah, that'll do. So we got what, like 12 people in here? I think that's okay. The other thing that I wouldn't mind doing is adding a little bit of storage in the middle. And when I say a little bit of storage, what I actually mean is, some equipment. So if we can do one, two, in fact, send this up to the ceiling. There we go. Send this up to the ceiling too. There we go. We could probably put like guns and stuff in here. So let's do that. Guns, rifle. Yeah, rifles are probably what we need. So one, two, three, and four. Hey, there we go. So we got some rifles right there. That seems a little strange though. I might want to do that differently, actually. I'm going to do that differently. I don't know whether you guys can tell. I got a really runny nose and I can barely speak right now. I'm trying though. I'm really trying. Right, rifles. I would imagine that they could actually go up here. So let's go ahead and add a rifle for everybody. There is, or at least 10. I want 10 rifles. There's 2, 3, 4, so 5, 6, 7, 8, and then we need another 2. We need another 2 somewhere. I'm thinking right here. So if I delete these, We should be able to fit these in. There we go. Okay, we got 10 rifles in the back. Excellent. We're then going to delete 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, extra rounds. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This seems a bit insane. It seems a little bit insane, but sure. We're then going to put extra ones in here. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Awesome. And we've obviously filled them in on that side too. Okay, that is a lot of ammo and also a lot of guns, but it's what we've got, so there you go. All right, jump inside, grab ourselves an actual gun, grab ourselves some ammo. Let's start shooting at this thing and see what happens. Okay, so I shot at all this. I wanted to see if the rounds would actually come through this, and luckily, they haven't. That's good. That's actually really good. Yeah. All right, I am seeing that this might be a bit of an issue, I'm not going to lie. I feel like it looks too ugly to have it like this, to be honest. And I'm not entirely sure how to fix that situation. Does this look too ugly? I would say yes. I might actually put these back in here and just leave them. That's okay. The other stuff that we actually need in there, equipment. Yes, so a flare gun is probably something that's quite useful. We'll actually add that right down here for the driver. All right, there we go. Driver's going to get a flare gun. Right there. And some ammunition for flare gun. This. Just like so. Because it might be that it is actually useful to get that and use that. So there you go. The other thing is a welder. That might actually be a very good thing to have inside of here. And we're going to have that on both sides. Here we go. And welder for everything. There we go. Good. What else would we need? An underwater welding torch? Not really, but maybe. First aid kits. Let's get a bunch of those. 1, 2, 3. All right, here we go. 1, 2, and 3. Ah, I can't get this right. Oh, there we go. Okay, so we got 6 of those. That seems fine. Realistically, I guess we should have one for every person, but never mind. Okay, what else do we need? An SMG? Maybe some of these rifles should be SMGs. I don't know. I feel like they would just carry their own rifles. It's not really down to the vehicle to give them that, is it? Not really. I think we need to get rid of the rifles. Maybe. I'm going to do it. I'm getting rid of them. We're not going to have rifles in here. Sorry, guys. I know I've just built all of them in, but we're not going to have them. There we go. And the main reason is, I don't think we need them. Not really. Not for what we're doing, anyway. So, go ahead and seal this off, just like so. All the way across the back of there. We still got all of this area for equipment and stuff like that, so all of that will stay, but yeah, no rifles. Okay, so what other equipment do we actually need in here then? I feel like ropes and also other stuff like ropes would actually be a very good thing to have in here. And what I might do, instead of putting them in like this, I might actually get ourselves some rope anchors, do-do-do-do-do, just like this, and we'll actually have them in the walls. So there we go across to there. Go from that one to that one. Go from that one to this one. And that should be good. But it's not. It should be good, but it's not. So put one there and put one there. And connect them all together via rope. Bam, bam, bam. There we go. And bam, and bam, and bam. All right, I might actually do this as well. And I might also do this too. There we go. Spawn it in. Let's see what that looks like. I'm not entirely sure, so we'll see. All right, open up the door. Alright, maybe not the ones going across, but everything else, yes. Maybe just not this one, actually. That one can stay. Yeah. Alright, cool. Okay, so the other thing is, I actually kind of want to start decorating the inside. I want to paint it, I want to make it look nice, etc, etc. So, the seats themselves are going to be brown. There we go. All of this bit, brown. That seems okay. That seems alright. We're then going to get a grey, and we're going to make the outside of this grey, just like so. Paint that in, paint this in, and paint all the bottom. There we go. And it is actually going to be very dark in here, but that should be okay. Alright, what color is the outside going to be? Let's go ahead and change that all together now. Bam. There we go. We're going to leave it that color for right now. That's okay. It means the inside is the same color as the outside in a lot of circumstances, so that's actually fine. The seats are not going to be the same color as the outside, though, so let's do this and this. And I feel like the front wall should actually be this color more like. Maybe even the seats should be this color too. I don't know. But let's go ahead and do this. We'll paint all of it in. There we go. And done. Voila. There we go. Very, very nice. Okay, that could stay like that. All right. We still got room up here for stuff. And I do keep, like, popping into my microphone, so I'm sorry. But yeah, we got more room for some things. So let's go ahead and grab those. Whatever they could be. Actually, a first aid kit for the driver. What else would we need for the driver? A compass, just in case? Yeah, sure. And one more thing, maybe even just a normal flare. One normal flare, bam. There we go. Good. Okay, that works. I'm not very good with interiors, as you guys probably already know. But that's okay. We don't have to be. We don't. Right, okay, delete all of this real quick. Get ourselves a fluid thingamabobby. And we're going to use that as the flooring. Yeah, we are. We could use these, actually. Like, they look kind of cool. I do like them. But at the same time, I don't know. And then what? There's another thing. This guy. Because this fits right in here. There we go. What do we think of that? Let's spawn it in. Let's have a little look in the back and see what we think. Do-do-do-do-do. Open sesame. Yeah, I mean, it looks weird. But I think it's fine. I'm going to paint the floor that color too, actually. So, let's go ahead and just jug it. There we go. Floor is now that color. Excellent. We're going to jug this bit too. And that bit's already done. Hey, there we go. Nice. All right, spawn it in. Let's see what that's like. Bam. All right, let's go have a little look. I'm not very good with interiors, but I'm trying my best. That actually looks okay. That one needs painting too, and then we're good. All right, hang on. Paint it. Here we go. Bosh. The only thing is, this bit's been painted by accident. So we're going to go ahead and paint that back the same color as the outside. And that should be A-okay. Good. Spawn it in again. And have a little look. Open sesame. Jump inside. Yes. This actually looks pretty sick. I like it. So obviously if you're a soldier, you'd sit in the back. And you'd just wait to get to your destination. Very slowly, it turns out. Because watch this. Look at how slow this thing moves. Oh, the engine doesn't work. I've broken something. I've broken something. I don't know what it was, though. Sag. All right, what's up with you? What is up with this engine? I don't actually know. I don't know. Does anyone know what's up with this engine? I think I deleted the fuel spawner. I'm almost 100% sure that's what just happened, but let's go ahead and do this. Here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Hey, it's working! And off we go. So clearly, it is far too slow for what we want. This is really, really slow. It does work, however, so that's good. But yeah, again, far too slow. But that is not too bad. That's okay. All right, anyway, what I want to do next is I want to actually add a ring. What is it called? Like a turret ring? Here we go. And I want it to be a medium one. I don't want any crew to actually be inside of this, but you'll see what I mean in a second. All right, so about there. All right, delete all of this. Delete all of that. There we go. Do it on both sides, please. All right, does this fit in there now? Yes, it does. Excellent. We're going to make this the same color as everything else, which is this. There we go. Whack that in there. Fill these guys in. There we go. Fill these guys in too. And there we go. Now we have a turret ring on the top. Very nice. And essentially what this is for is to actually reload the gun if we need to. Which also means we need some ammo inside the tank in order to actually reload the gun. But that should be okay. Nice. Yes. It's working. Oh my goodness, I didn't actually check this before, but yes, we need the catalytic converters in here because otherwise this is our situation. The other thing is that a few of you guys have said that maybe we actually need a bigger engine. And you'd be correct, you would be. Because I can't change the amount of cylinders or the amount of fuel that goes into the cylinders, etc, etc. We are just going to have to go with the bigger cylinders, which means this might actually only be like a 2-cylinder engine. But it'll be right, if that makes sense. Anyway, we're in the water, so I figured this would be fun. like, we can jump out the top. Woo! Nice! Right, okay, turn this off. Turn this off, it's too noisy. Too noisy. But yeah, the gun would obviously be on the top. It is amphibious, it's gonna be amphibious. This is gonna be sick. This is gonna be really cool. I feel like we need another way out of this thing, though. And the way that we're gonna have to do that is probably by adding another hatch. We might actually have to add a hatch to the top, which is slightly annoying. It might even do a 2. I don't know, is that a good idea? It might not be a good idea. But here we go, hatch. Let's go ahead and grab one. We'll shove it on the right way around. And yeah, that's going to be our way in and out if we need to. Like if we really, really need to. So go ahead and close this up. If we open this hatch, can we get to that? Just about. Only a little bit, but yes. And then we should be able to get out using that. There we go. Okay, sick. All right, good. So we've done the interior a little bit. I feel like we should add a light as well. That actually doesn't look too bad in there. I don't mind it. All right, so I've done like a rudimentary job with these lights, but honestly, it might be where they end up being anyway. So if we go ahead and do this and we close the door and we also make it nighttime, you guys will be able to see exactly what it looks like. In fact, let's go outside first too. Here we go. Have I somehow broken the engine again? I didn't do anything. Oh, I did. Turns out I did. I've deleted the air thingy-ma-bobby, the actual air supply. All right, we'll leave the hatch in on one side. We'll delete it on the other side, and we're going to have to leave it like that. That's okay. All right, go to the underside, grab one of these. There we go. Take it back up and put it on there and spawn it in again. Let's move it outside, and yeah, we'll see what the lights look like now. Here we go. Jump in, close this up, turn those on, get outside. Here we go. I also might actually make this an IR camera too, so we'll put a button in for IR. So we can see in the dark. But here we go, we're going outside. You can't really see the lights from it, not really. So that's good. And then once we are outside, let's turn the engine off and have a little look around. Yeah, you know what? It's a little bit bare in here and it is actually way bigger than you'd want it to be. But we can actually transport some stuff in here too, which means I'm happy with it. That's okay. And I don't mind it being quite as bare as it is. I think it's all right. Anyway, this is going to be our gunner seat. We're going to make our gun soon. I might actually put a hatch in here so we can fix the engine from the inside. Maybe? I don't know. And yeah, we need to sort out the engine too, so we'll do that as well. But yeah. Honestly, I'm actually really happy with the way this is going. So for now, I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.